Perfect.
And we're happy to be talking once again to Vincent Martella.
Yes.
Phineas, or here on the sheet they gave us today, it says Dr. Phineas Stein.
Does it really?
It really does. Look at it right there. Dr. Phineas Stein.
That's fantastic.
What does that mean?
That's from our episode where we are basically reenacting Frankenstein. And I am Dr. Phineas Stein.
Dr. Phineas Stein.
And yeah, we create a Perry the Platypus monster, and Ferb is basically Igor. It's a very, very great episode. That's hilarious that they put that on there. That's what I'm known for, though.
Well, it and of course, you obviously did such a fantastic job that they had to let people know that. Well, now you're here today for Mars Needs Moms. First of all, have Phineas and Ferb managed to travel to other planets?
We have. We've been to Mars before, and we went and we experienced a Martian science fair whilst helping Valji with his science fair project, which is a portal to Mars. And so we do encounter Martians, and they praise Candace, and they make her their queen.
Ah, well, so Martians not that bright, perhaps.
Not the brightest, no. Not the quickest aliens. Just then we're going to get invaded, because I said that. Watch.
Now, do you mind talking about your mom?
No, of course. Yeah,
now, since this is Mars Needs Mom, possibly would Mars need your mom?
I think everyone needs my mom, just as a general rule. If you haven't met my mother, your life isn't complete.
And what would your mom be able to do for Mars?
Well, she's an incredibly fun and funny person. She's very quick-witted. So I think she'd give a little life to that lifeless planet that they're living on.
Okay, well, thanks for stopping and talking with us, and we'll let you head in and see Mars Needs Moms.
Cool, thank you very much.
Thank you.